Hello, my name is Ivan Koletic, and I'm a product manager in a Business Central product team. And I want to welcome you to the Business Central launch event. I'm super excited to tell you about what's new in Dataverse and Dynamics 365 apps integration. This session's agenda covers following five improvements that we are introducing in 2023 release wave 2, and some that you might have missed as they have been introduced in July as part of the minor updates for 2023 release wave 1. So we'll talk about how to connect and integrate Business Central with Dataverse and Dynamics 365 applications in configurations involving multiple environments, multiple companies, and different base currencies. We'll also walk through how users can synchronize even more data out of the box through additional fields mapping without a need for a developer, and how to better control your data synchronization and enable virtual tables. So let's dig in. With 2023 release wave 2, you can now unlock scenarios where multiple companies from multiple Business Central environments must access data in the same Dataverse environments. This enables partners to build new experiences when working in more than one company, environment, or base currency. When you enable multi-company synchronization, following things happen. You get warned of the changes that will happen to integration filters and some recommendations for selected integration table mappings. After that, the company filters get removed on user and team-owned tables, such as account or contact tables. Sales quotes and order synchronization becomes more restrictive with respect to company filters. Users now must pick company in Dynamics 365 sales to specify the Business Central company that will process a particular document. This is to avoid companies hijacking each other's documents. And the last thing, this setting has no effect on the tables that are organization-owned in Dataverse, such as currency table. Users can now pick and change the default Business Central environment and company that will be used to open coupled records from Dynamics 365 for sales in Business Central. This information is preserved as a per-user setting, but this can be changed anytime by the user. This is mainly to avoid users picking a Business Central company every time they need to open a coupled record in Dynamics 365 for sales or Dataverse. Documents such as sales quotes or orders requires users to pick target Business Central environment and company that will process a specific document. As mentioned, for documents, company filters are now stricter on company filtering, meaning sales quotes and orders without explicit company define will no longer show up in the list of sales quotes and orders that you can synchronize with a particular Business Central company. More complex configurations of synchronizing data to a central Dataverse or Dynamics 365 sales environment are also supported. It's good to know that multi-environment and multi-company synchronization works across Azure Active Directory tenants as long as you are synchronizing data to a central Dataverse or Dynamics 365 for sales deployment. If you are dealing with many companies, consider consolidating data you want to synchronize in one master data company in Business Central. And then you use master data management capabilities of Business Central to synchronize master data between Business Central companies. And after that, integrate such master data company that contains the consolidated master data from Business Central companies with a central Dataverse or Dynamics 365 sales deployment. The result of this approach will be more performance synchronization and less chance of hitting the service protection limits on the Dataverse side. It is also very important to keep local data privacy and data storage requirements in mind, as you want to make sure that data remains within the privacy boundaries when you're doing synchronization. You could ask, but doesn't synchronizing multiple environments and company necessarily mean necessarily require dealing with multiple currencies? Well, yes. When integrating with Dynamics 365 or sales or just Dataverse in environments where there's a central deployment of those apps and where you're serving multiple markets, it's important that the integration to Business Central can accommodate for differences in local and base transaction currencies between those two systems. Integration now ensures seamless synchronization when multiple currencies are involved. So when a Dataverse-based currency and Business Central local currencies are different, the following things happen. The only prerequisite that you have is having Dataverse-based currency set up as a regular currency in Business Central with at least one exchange rate in order to enable connection. Otherwise, you won't be able to connect because the integration needs to know about this non-local base currency that exists in Dataverse. Then when you connect to Dataverse, Business Central's local currency is added to the list of currencies in Dataverse automatically. Integration converts monetary amounts on the fly. This means when converting amounts from Business Central local currency, the amounts synchronize with a Business Central local currency in one of the additional or inserted or non-base currencies in Dataverse. On the other way, when converting amounts from Dataverse-based transaction currency, amounts are converted to Business Central local currency based on the latest exchange rate synchronized from Business Central. Companies often customize their integration between Business Central and Dataverse to fit their specific business needs. To make that easier to do without the help of a developer, we made more fields available for mapping in our standard integration table mappings. So customer, vendor, contact, salesperson, and opportunity integration field mappings now have additional fields available for you to map. These additional fields are disabled by default. However, in order to use them, you simply open integration field mapping page, choose the direction, and enable them. Turning off event-based synchronization for specific integration table mappings can give you greater control over the flow of data between Business Central and Dataverse. For example, you can reduce the risk of the data errors, inconsistencies, and improve the overall quality and reliability of the data. Additionally, opting out of event-based synchronization can speed up performance by reducing the number of synchronization events that Business Central needs to process. The default settings for the event-based synchronization stay unchanged to avoid disrupting existing integrations. For some time, we've been talking about virtual tables and data synchronization as complementary integration technologies, and we'll continue to invest in both technologies together to provide even more value. Avoiding duplicate data entry is one of the key value propositions for integrating Business Central with Dataverse, and enabling virtual tables makes more data available between Business Central and Dataverse, which enriches integrations without additional customizations. When there's overlapping data in Dataverse or Dynamics 365 applications such as sales, your choice should be data synchronization. And when that's not the case, the virtual table will offer integration customization with less effort. So now when you enable and connect to Dataverse using assisted setup, you are now able to make specific virtual tables visible already during the setup. This can be done for a single table or in bulk for multiple tables. To make additional virtual tables available, you can later on access the list of the Dataverse available tables from the connection setup page as well. Now that we are done with the technical improvements, it's also good to know, as many of you have asked us, that the commercial blockers for integrating various Dynamics 365 apps have been removed. Earlier this year, we've announced a set of attached licenses for Business Central Premium license and for enterprise versions of sales, customer service, and field service, making you more competitive when pricing an integration project. Make sure to check out the details below on the partner portal on the following links. And now let's see all of the above in action in one short demo. To prepare for this demo, I've already connected Kronos US to the Kronos HQ Dataverse environment, and I've installed Virtual Tables app to that environment. As you can see, that both sales and Dataverse connection setup are enabled in Kronos US. Let's go and switch to Kronos DE. I picked the environment and signed in as an administrator and enabled synchronization and virtual tables, just so we don't have to go through those steps. Even though I want to connect without full sync, as there's obviously already data in Dataverse environments, let's continue. Let's click next to see the sync recommendations anyway. So let's check the synchronization recommendation. What you can see in here, there are two types of recommendation. One other thing to notice is that there is a sort of a new type of recommendation that is called review coupling criteria, where for some simple tables like payment terms or currencies, we can automatically recommend coupling criteria so users don't need to do and review them or set them up manually. As you can see here, for payment terms, we only have one field, so it's obvious which field we will use for coupling criteria. For master data, such as contact, customer, or vendors, Business Central recommends full synchronization as current integration table filters don't catch data already synced from Tronus US. You will also notice there's a multi-company sync enabled column that has been added. So let's try to toggle multi-company synchronization enabled. So there's a new action that says toggle multi-company synchronization. You get a confirmation if you want to proceed, and then you'll also get informed about filters being changed. And another warning comes up which explains things in details. And let's click OK. And now with the filters removed, after we enabled the multi-company synchronization, some data that is already synchronized, for example, let's click on contacts, is actually available and the recommendation changes from full synchronization to selecting coupling criteria. And if we would want to go and do that, we could go there, select the coupling criteria, and repeat this for every integration table mapping that we want to do. But we'll do that later in the demo. So let's flip this back and just proceed with this. Yes, I want to do that. Okay. Let's click OK here. And let's go back and let's turn off the synchronization. Click Next. Now that we are not doing initial synchronization, and as I said in the beginning, the virtual table setup was enabled, we can actually go and review and enable virtual tables right from the wizard. When I click Review and Enable Virtual Tables, available virtual table pages opens up. So let's make a sales, shipment, and lines virtual tables visible right from here. Let me find sales, shipment, and sales, shipment line. And let's enable. While this is completed in the background, we can simply go ahead and click Finish in the wizard. Okay, and one other thing to do, what we can do in here, we can also go and enable a connection to Dynamics 365 for sales. Let's just go ahead and enable that. So what you can see is we've enabled Dataverse, Sales Connection, made virtual tables visible directly from Business Central. What you may notice also is there were no complaints about local currency being different from the Dataverse base currency. We can actually go ahead and check that in general ledger setup. For this company, you can see there's a euro currency in here. So let's go and actually integrate a few things in the multi-company scenario. To do that, I will open integration table mappings and just go and couple my accounts. As we saw in the warning, the recommendation, if I were to go and enable this, and say yes, but you can see from the warning, the recommendation in here is to change the integration direction from bidirectional sync to from integration table mapping. And to do this, we need to have some field set to pick the data from Dataverse. So let's go and do that. Let's turn this off. And if we go to mapping, open fields, well, you can see a lot of our fields are bidirectional. Let's go ahead and edit list. What I want to do is I do want to map the number to the account number that we have in there. So what you see in here, this is one of these additional fields that are disabled, that are part of the out-of-the-box field mappings that come disabled by default, but you can, of course, go ahead and enable them. The things that I don't want to integrate for the demo purposes, just let me just go ahead and disable a couple of these things. And of course, I don't want a currency code. And what I'll do, I will say I want the name to come from integration table and the website, for example. Okay, that sets us up. Right now, we can actually go ahead and change the direction of the integration table to from integration table mapping, and then go ahead and enable multi-company synchronization. Okay, and the last thing I need to do is I would want to run my match-based coupling. Let's say yes, let's expand this, and let's go and say I want to do this like this. I'll just say, let's do this coupling. So let's go to one of the customers. We should actually have them coupled already. Let's go and try to open that customer in Dynamics A65 for sales. And the thing that you can hear see in here is this new button that allows each user to set up a default connection. So I can go and click choose default Business Central connection. And in here, for example, I will pick Kronos DE as the one that I want. Save and close. And then when I want to open a coupled customer or a coupled account, when I click open in Business Central, it should actually go ahead and take me to this other environment that I have integrated, this Kronos DE. So let's also see the sales orders. And let's designate one company that has been integrated to pick up this particular sales order. Let's say that this particular one is going to be picked up by Kronos DE. Save that. Oh, I do need to pick the potential customer. Let's make this a customer and save. I've enabled virtual tables. So let's have a look at the tables that I actually have available in here. And I will just look for sales shipments. So both of these virtual tables that we've decided to make visible through the wizard are now available in here. So this concludes the demo. In the demo, you saw how integration works in multi-company and multi-environment setting, conversion of base transaction currency, making virtual tables visible, and enablement of additional field mappings. This is, of course, not all that has been improved in Business Central and Dataverse integration. So if you want to learn more about the improvements in virtual tables, create, update, delete events, external business events, or more, make sure to watch the session delivered by Sandy. As always, if there are further questions or you just want to be kept up to date, have a product suggestion, or want to connect to a product team in any way, make sure to check the links on this slide. And with that, and on behalf of Business Central product team and myself, I want to thank you for your time and for joining this session. Make sure to try out the improvements presented and provide feedback to us. Looking forward to seeing you or meeting you in one of our next events. Thank you.